fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. Yes, clap for the heavyweight champ, me. But I couldn't do it all alone. We, Young Money raised me, grew up out in Paisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy. Cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Best believe that when we done, this moment will be syndicated. I don't know, this night just remind me of everything they deprived me of. Put your drinks up, it's a celebration every time we link up. We done did everything.
OMG, what's poppin', America? What's poppin', what's poppin', what's poppin'? How you doing? Yo, I know I probably don't even sound like my normal self and all this shit. Don't worry, America, I'm still here. You know, I'm still alive. You know what I mean? I thank God every fucking day that I sit here and I wake up that I'm still alive. Now, I know a lot of you don't even know what I'm talking about, but there's some shit that happened to me the other day. Thursday night, coming home from work. You know, I'm walking down the strip or whatever right before I get to my crib, and it's crazy. I got hit by a snowplow, you know what I mean? I got hit by a fucking snowplow, man. Like, I still seem like this shit's just a fucking dream to me. You know, it still seems like, you know, it didn't even happen, but it's just like it did. You know, dude hit me, he came up from the back, and whatnot. I didn't even see, dude. Like, I looked both ways before I crossed the street. No, I wasn't on the highway. I was just on a regular street. You know, there's no fucking street lights. There's no goddamn sidewalk. So it's just like I'm risking my life every fucking day. You know, and walking home from work, and next thing you know, dude clips me. Alright? And the only thing I remember was spinning up in the air, you know, three times and shit like that. I remember seeing the dude, I remember what the truck looks like, you know, I don't remember the license plate, but all I remember is when I'm in the air and shit spinning, I remember this dude slowing down, you know, he puts on his brakes for a second, but then he peels off. There was another car behind him, motherfucker kept going and shit, punk bitch didn't sit here and stop to fucking assist me, nobody fucking helped me, America. And it's shit like that, that you got no fucking respect. You got no motherfucking respect. Didn't your parents teach you something? If you see somebody injured on the highway, at least pull over, see if they're okay. You know, call 911, something. Nobody did shit to fucking help me. And I'm just like, I thank God that I'm fucking alive. Like, I can't believe this shit. I thought my arm was broken. You know, I wound up getting rushed to the fucking ambulance. I mean, rushed to the ambulance. Rushed to the hospital and shit like that. Y'all gotta forgive me, because I wound up taking my pain medication and shit like that. Yes, we are legally prescribed to have these pills. You know, so I'm a little out of it right now. I'm a little fucking out of it. But, you know, I get to the fucking hospital. I'm sitting here, you know, going in and out from the pain. I got the x-rays and shit done. After sitting in the fucking hospital for 5.5 fucking hours, you know, dealing with fucking bullshit, trying to fill out papers and trying to remember everything that's fucking happening. And it just amazes me, America, that nobody stopped to help me. Like, first of all, I can't believe I got hit by a snowplow. You know, even just laying in a hospital bed and it's like not being able to move, you know, without fucking pain shooting up through my entire body. You know, my whole left side of my body right now is in so much pain, but you know, I'm getting through it to come talk to you guys. You know, it's stupid, idiotic drivers. You gotta pay attention, you know. You gotta pay attention when you're going on these roads and shit, man. People fucking give you street signs that tell you the rules of the road of, you know, certain fucking speed limits that you're supposed to abide by. And if you don't go by those fucking speed limits, shit like this happens. Alright, dude had to be going at least 40, 45. Because of the fact that if he didn't go that fast, I wouldn't have flipped up in the air like that. Okay, so you had to be going well over the speed limit of fucking 30 going down that road, my nigga. And honestly, that's fucked up how I think that you say you just stopped for a brief second. You didn't even get out the car because I know that you fucking hit something. You know that you fucking hit something, motherfucker. And you don't even come to check to see if whatever you hit, what it, the fuck it was. And then you're going to fucking book. And on top of it, for the bitch motherfucker that was behind you that saw the fucking bullshit. That's what kills me. You saw the fucking shit. You don't fucking check to see if I'm okay. I could have been fucking dead. The fuck is wrong with half of you stupid, ignorant motherfuckers, yo? You got your fucking driver's license, and here it is. I'm the one that's fucking struggling to get my shit, trying to get my fucking shit together. And you got stupid motherfuckers like you on the motherfucking road, trying to take a nigga's life. Oh, what the fuck were you doing on a Thursday night? What were you drinking? You punk son of a bitch, because it wasn't snowing. Alright? It wasn't fucking snowing. So, there was no fucking snow. Don't sit here and give me no fucking bullshit, bitch, because you had your goddamn lights on. You had quite a few set of motherfucking lights on. So don't tell me that you didn't fucking see me. Alright? Some fucking fucked up bullshit. And I'm the motherfucker stuck with the goddamn bill. You punk son of a bitch. Ooh. No. There's no alcohol in here. This shit is fucking virginized, okay? I'm not that stupid. I'm just highly upset about that shit, America. I can't believe the fucking bullshit. You know, I mean, I have a fucking bruise on my arm that goes wrapped around my motherfucking arm. My jacket. Oh my god. America, I gotta show you this shit. Look at this shit. It's fucking destroyed. Hello? It's fucking destroyed, America. My jacket is destroyed. I have no fucking winter coat. You know, you hit me so hard, motherfucker, it went right through the bitch. Hello? America, do you see this? Do you see this, America? Do you see this bullshit? Because you know I'm going to fuck in. Look at this. Look at this. There's still fucking blood in this son of a bitch. I can't. It's already been enough fucking bullshit as it is. And it's like, I gotta go through this fucking shit now. Just no fucking respect. And speaking of fucking respect, you know, I was speaking to a friend of mine today. He's having some problems and shit with kicking his business and shit off. You know, it works out there in Tarrytown. I can't remember the name of the store right now. You know, so you gotta forgive me, my man, but he's working in a store in Tarrytown, and y'all motherfuckers don't treat him with no kind of respect because of the fact that, who's calling me? She's gonna have to wait. You don't give him no type of respect because, one, he's fucking Italian, and he's a little bit dark-skinned compared to y'all motherfuckers, and not to mention, because of the fact that he's fucking gay? Are you serious? Y'all motherfuckers need to get over the bullshit. It is 2011. I'm fucking gay, and y'all bitches respect me. Why can't you respect the next motherfucker? I might not know everybody in the gay community, but my heart does go out there for all of them that has to go through some shit that goes worse through me. Or worse than I go through. Whatever the fuck. You know, people get fucking shot and stabbed and killed and fucking hung. All because of their fucking lifestyle. And you punk motherfuckers out there can't accept the bullshit, but you're on a fucking down low as well? Bitch, please, spare me the motherfucking bullshit, okay? Get the fuck over it. You got a motherfucking problem? You know what, bitch? I take my shit off. I take all this shit off. Alright? Fuck. Injured in motherfucking all. Like, yo, I'll fight all y'all motherfuckers for all my fucking gay brethren out there, yo. Is that shit right there? That shit ain't cool, man. That shit's not fucking cool. Get over it. Just get over the fucking bullshit. Seriously. It's a fucking new, brand new fucking year. Niggas should not have to go through this shit. We're already in a motherfucking recession. And now I gotta worry about how the fuck am I gonna pay this goddamn hospital bill. My man's is worrying about how he's gonna have to pay his fucking bills. And punk motherfuckers don't give us enough fucking credit and respect. You know, and this shit just kills me. It fucking kills me how ungrateful some motherfuckers is. Everybody's sitting here talking about how next year that the world is gonna fucking end. You know what my goddamn opinion on this shit is? Too fucking bad. You guys had how many fucking years to try and change this goddamn earth around into something a little bit more productive and all that fucking shit. And all you guys did was bullshit. America, get y'all's fucking nose. No. global. We'll go to the global now. Everybody needs to stop worrying about everybody else's shit and come back and fucking worry about the real motherfucking Americans, the real motherfuckers that's out there busting their fucking ass day in, day out from, you know, all types of fucking crazy hours, from the early bird shift to the afternoon shift to the graveyard shift. We're the motherfuckers that's out there busting our fucking asses while these rich motherfuckers is living so oh high and fucking mighty on their high horse. Bitch, fuck you and the goddamn high horse that you rode up in on. Alright? Give us some fucking credibility, because we're the ones that's paying your motherfucking taxes and all that bullshit. Alright? This is why our fucking rates are so goddamn high, but y'all bitches are sitting here chilling in beaches and shit. That's why I don't talk about celebrities, because y'all motherfuckers ain't doing shit for us, so why am I gonna do shit for you? Fuck out of here. You done lost your goddamn mind. Alright? And honestly, I've had it with that fucking bullshit. Also, I get another fucking phone call with one of my people, who I haven't spoken to in quite some time. Reason being, it's not even that important. But to hear the fucking bullshit conversation going on in the background, like, you don't even give this nigga any kind of respect? The fuck? Like, if somebody's... I can't even do it, yo. If somebody's giving you fucking advice about some fucking bullshit, granted, it's up to you for you to take the motherfucking advice, but if somebody's giving you fucking advice to sit here and benefit for your own fucking self, so that way you don't sit here and turn around and make any stupid mistakes or decisions, if somebody's giving you advice, motherfucker, just shut the fuck up for once, for one goddamn second, just shut the fuck up and listen. That's how all these problems and shit come about, and it drives me fucking crazy. Everybody's so worried about being under the next person's ass, you know, worried about what this person's doing, what that person's doing, what this person done did and said about them. Too fucking bad. Let them talk. That's like me. I don't give a fuck what nobody says about me, yo. On some G shit. You're not even dealing with Antonio right now. You're dealing with Anthony. You're dealing with the real me right now. I don't give a fuck what nobody says about me. You got some shit to say about me? You got the cojones to sit here and talk shit about me behind my back? Bitch, come address that shit to my fucking face. Okay? Because this shit right here, no. This shit right here, yo, this shit is not cool. I got an entire bruise going around my fucking arm. My fucking neck. If it wasn't for these goddamn pills, my left side of my fucking body is shot. Because of you punk motherfuckers. Don't know how to drive. But you got a responsible motherfucker like me that's trying to get their shit fucking done. I can't get the shit done because you stupid punk motherfuckers out there don't know what the fuck you're doing. That's why people fucking smoke and do drugs and drink and all the fucking shit that they fucking do. Because they're trying to make a fucking decent ends meet. They're trying to sit here and do something positive with themselves and all that. And what happens? They get fucking shitted on. Oh, and speaking of motherfuckers getting shitted on, I don't understand how fuck-ups out there fuck up their entire lives, and then when they decide to sit here and change, alright, after doing so much negative shit, when they decide to sit here and change just like that, shit goes oh so fucking well for them. But you got a motherfucker like me, who, yes, I did have occasional fuck-ups, I did do this, I did do that, but I turned everything around. Where the fuck is my fucking prize? Where's my car? Where's my fucking pay increase? Where's this? Where's that? How the fuck are you guys getting apprehended and getting awards and all this shit for the shit? That's crazy. That's motherfucking crazy. Because of the fact that people of my generation, they didn't all bust their ass and shit like I did. Nobody been through half the fucking stupid shit that I had to do. Granted, there's some shit I may have put my fucking self through, and I wound up working the shit out, but there's other shit that I didn't fucking ask for. None of us asked to be put on this fucking earth. None of us. Nobody asked to be here. But once we got here, and some of the people that's smart enough to do what the fuck they gotta do, they handled this shit. They put a H on their chest, and they handled the motherfucker. It kills me. It fucking kills me. It just fucking kills me, yo. I just don't get how people just have no fucking, you know, just human decency, man. I I don't know. This is why I do what I do. But you know what? I can't. This is why I sit here and I say, I can't deal with the bullshit. This is why I smoke cigarettes. This is why I drink on occasion. This is why I do what I do. This is why I even make this web show, to come out and talk to you guys, because some people do some stupid fucked up shit. But you know what, America? It's that time. I gotta go. So you already know what time it is. It's time to chuck up the deuces, because you know what? Half of you bitches out there is not cooler than me. Okay? Alright, y'all. I'll talk to you later. Deuces!
What's that puff puff ass shit? Cheech and Chong grass shit. Blunts to the head. Cush pillows, no mattress. Speedboat traffic. Bitches automatic. Cross that line. Fuck around and get your ass kicked. We roll shit and burn slow as fucking molasses. Probably won't pass it. Smoke until the last hit. Down to the ashes. Mary J, a bad bitch. Andre 3001. Another classic. Go ahead, ask them. Bitches about how I be smoking out. Party all night. Oh, yeah, it's going down. Quarter rounds. We smoke a quarter pound of that good stuff. Oh, yeah, we smoking all night. Yeah, puff puff, pass that shit right here. Nigga better than my last batch. Caramel complexion and an ass fat.